Hey, sweet friends, welcome back. I'm so glad that you're here with me this morning. Today, I thought it'd be fun to sort of vlog my morning and just kind of share the healthy habits that I've been focusing on, as well as just share how I'm really focusing on my home and being a homemaker and a mom and how I'm sort of balancing it all. But like every typical morning, I start it with a piping hot cup of coffee with my Vital Proteins collagen powder. I've been doing this for years, actually, and it's my absolute favorite way to start the day. Okay, at this point now I've had some coffee. I just ran and dropped the kids off at school really quick and hopped back home for an at-home workout. I usually try to squeak in about an hour or so, and you know, the earlier I can get this done in the day, the more likely I am to get it done altogether. And for anyone looking to start running or strength training, I encourage you, don't get shiny object syndrome. Find a plan that works for you, that you love, and keep your head down and stay focused and stick with it. Be consistent. Don't go changing your plans every other day or every other week. I've been there, I've made that mistake. Just be consistent with something. You don't have to be perfect, just consistent, and I promise it'll be worth it. After my workout, it's usually a quick shower, didn't wash the hair, and a quick 5-minute makeup routine. Nothing fancy, just want to feel like myself and feel a little bit put together for the day. If you see me talking, I was actually on the phone with my mom while I was getting ready. And this is just your gentle reminder to call the people in your life that mean a lot to you. We're not guaranteed tomorrow. If there's a loved one, a relative, a friend you haven't talked to in a while, give them a call. I promise, you won't regret it.
That everything seems to crumble around you. I know that you feel all alone in this world, but you have to put your trust into us, and we will help.
And nothing says mental clarity like making your bed for the day. Even if it's not perfect, even if it's not pretty, get it made and you will feel so much better. I promise. So for breakfast this morning, I'm gonna make a smoothie. I had this Core Power protein milk on hand and it is jam-packed with protein. I used about half of that, so it had about 20 grams of protein, about half a banana, a tablespoon or so of peanut butter, about a tablespoon of hemp seeds. These are also great for some added plant protein and fiber. And then I'm gonna add some blueberries full of antioxidants and some spinach. And this was delicious and ended up being about 30 grams of protein to start my day, which not only tastes great, but keeps me feeling full until lunch. And I've just found that I've really been enjoying a smoothie lately. 2023, I got myself in the habit of starting and finishing one load of laundry a day, and I start that load of laundry while my coffee is brewing in the morning, and then I, you know, roll it over right away, and then I usually have a load done by 8 or 9 o'clock in the morning, and it's been a game changer.
Well, good official morning, friends. I am wrapping up my last cup of coffee. I just finished up that smoothie. It was delicious whenever I'm in a pinch and I don't have a ton of groceries on hand. Making a smoothie is pretty much always my go-to. But today, I hope you're kind of enjoying this spend the day with me, spend the morning with me. We're also going to be doing a what I eat in a day, starting with that protein shake smoothie I just had for breakfast. But before I make lunch today, I actually need to go pick up some groceries pretty desperately. So we'll head over to Aldi. I'll come back and do a little Aldi haul, and we'll just kind of see what the day brings. But before we go any farther in today's video, I did want to just take a quick moment and thank today's video sponsor, BetterHelp. I have seen such a huge difference in my overall mental health and emotional well-being ever since starting therapy with BetterHelp back 8 or 9 months ago at this point. And at this season of life, I currently do a weekly call with my therapist. And it is something that I truly now look forward to so much. Sometimes it's just nice to have a third party person who doesn't have any bias, who can professionally speak into your life and really just give you the tools you need to handle certain situations. If you aren't familiar, BetterHelp is an online therapy platform with over 30,000 licensed therapists that specialize in all sorts of needs. And finding a therapist is as simple as filling out a questionnaire, answering your preferences, what you're looking for in a therapist, and in most cases, you'll get matched with a therapist in as little as 48 hours. And BetterHelp can be a little bit like dating in that it might take a few therapists to figure out what's right for you. And that's totally okay because changing therapists through the BetterHelp app is as simple as a click of a button in the settings, and it comes at no additional cost to you, which is awesome. Having an app like BetterHelp really helped me find a therapist that fits my needs and works with my lifestyle. It's great because you can schedule your therapy sessions around a time that's convenient for you, and your therapy sessions can look like a video call, a phone call, or even messaging through the BetterHelp app. I encourage you, join the 4 million people who have started using therapy through BetterHelp to live an overall healthier, happier life, myself included, by using the link down in the description below or by going to betterhelp.com/AmyFritz, and you will receive 10% off of your first month's therapy. And again, a big thanks to BetterHelp for sponsoring today's video.
Okay, it is around lunchtime now. I just got back from running errands most of the morning and running to Aldi, and we are going to make some delicious sweet potato barbecue chicken nachos for lunch.
Okay, to get started, I'm going to preheat my oven to 425 and get that going.
Okay, this is not hard at all. It's very easy to make. It's a little time consuming, but not too bad. I start by slicing up a whole sweet potato. I leave the skin on just to make life easier. And I coat the sweet potato in a bowl with some olive oil, some salt, pepper, paprika, chili powder, garlic powder. I just season it really, really well. And then once the potato rounds are nice and coated, I just place them on a baking sheet with some parchment paper and I cook them for 20 minutes.
Okay, sweet potatoes have about 10 more minutes in the oven. When they are done, they're gonna come out and I'm gonna top them with a bunch of chicken. I've got some rinsed black beans here. I just need, just try to get some more, you know, fiber going in my diet. And then I'm going to also top it with some Mexican cheese and put it back in the oven for 5 minutes, let the cheese melt. It'll come out, we'll top it with some yummy stuff. I've got some barbecue sauce, some pickled jalapeno and red onion, and oh my word, so delicious. Oh my word, does that not just look amazing? But final touch is just a little drizzle. You don't need a lot, but it's definitely a step you don't want to skip. It's just a little bit of barbecue sauce. You can use whatever kind you prefer. I'm trying to do like a tablespoon-ish, but yum. Time for lunch. Sat down to eat my delicious meal, and I wanted to mention something. As you know, a work from home mom, I'm trying to just keep things like not fussy and just easy, no mess, no long cleanup afterwards. And so I threw everything on the baking sheet with parchment paper. And then when it was done and it's time to eat, I just lift the parchment paper up with the nachos intact and I just put it on a cutting board and that works as my plate. And then I don't have to do any dishes, and it's delicious, easy, super simple. Love it. It's been a go-to lately. And to drink, I'm going to have a Spindrift. And hopefully after this, I can get back to work this afternoon, but I will check back in later. Okay, friends, it's now about 2:45 in the afternoon. Usually around this time, sometime between 2 and 3, I start to get a little hungry, and I like to have a little snack to tide me over until dinner. And so I'm just sitting at my desk here getting some work done, but I have a half a cup of cottage cheese, just a tiny drizzle, like a teaspoon's worth of honey, and a handful of blueberries here. And it kind of kicks a sweet tooth for me in the afternoon. Again, it's really high protein. Half a cup of cottage cheese is 13 grams of protein. So it's going to keep me feeling full and it's delicious. And yeah, so cheers to snack time. I'll see you guys at dinner.
Okay, hey guys. Coming up on dinner time, I'm heating up a skillet now, and we're doing a teriyaki shrimp stir fry tonight for dinner. This is super simple. It's hardly even a recipe, but I'm just heating up some oil. I think I did avocado oil tonight. I love this meal to keep in the weekly rotation because I pretty much always have shrimp on hand. And then I can just plug and play whatever veggies I want, whether they're frozen, fresh. It's an easy meal to whip up fast and it's fairly healthy. So we're gonna do broccoli and red pepper tonight because that's what I have on hand. So I'm just gonna add it to my skillet and let it saute and cook up for a few minutes and soften, and then we'll add the shrimp.
So this is the shrimp that I'm using today. You know, shrimp is one of those high volume foods you can eat a lot of for not a lot of calories and a lot of nutrients. You can see here, 7 shrimp, which is a serving size. You could eat more if you wanted because it's only 90 calories and 21 grams of protein. So you really can't beat those numbers. I'm probably gonna make up this whole bag and that will definitely feed Caleb and I. Like I mentioned, or maybe I didn't mention earlier, I don't know. My kids aren't super crazy about shrimp. They might have like a piece or two, but they'll definitely enjoy the chicken in the chicken fried rice I have cooking up. Thank you. Hey friends, this looks so delicious. It's got all these beautiful colors with all the veggies from the fried rice and then the stir fry. It's gonna be nice and filling with that rice and the shrimp. It's tons of protein. So overall, I feel like it's a pretty well-rounded meal to end the day. My family's waiting on me to plate their food so we can all eat. So I just wanted to quickly film this little outro and say thank you so much for watching today's What I Eat in a Day and just kind of spending the day with me. I really appreciate you for sticking around, for watching, and I'm so thankful for you. I hope that today's video gave you some recipe ideas or just general meal and nutrition inspiration. If you liked today's video, be sure to give it a thumbs up or maybe share it with a friend. And I will see you guys really soon in my next video.